Again to this refreshing moment in the presence of the Lord. And I do hope that the Lord has continually been your help up to now. Can I implore us to bow down our hearts as we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for another hour of refreshing in your presence. We want to appreciate you for all that you have continually done in our lives, for preserving us even at these very challenging times. Father, we bless you. Thank you for how we started. Thank you for what you will do today. Thank you for your word that will come out today as it's going to meet, Lord, even with situations and circumstances in the hearts of men. Father, we beseech the Holy Spirit to guide our thoughts. We beseech the Holy Spirit to teach us all things in the name of Jesus. So that at the end of this very moment with one another, we will have every cause to glorify your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
I welcome you again to this second chapter of what we started before. And remember, we've been talking about different spirits in troubled times. What actually propelled us to this stage? To this
team?
We were looking at the environment. We were looking at the times that we are in now. We are looking at everything that is happening in our surroundings. And we need not be told that the times are actually not as they used to be.
So last
edition, we looked at the reality of the time that we are in. And we read the book of Luke chapter 21 from verses 20 to 36. Where God was telling us about all the signs, or some of the signs that will begin to unfold as we get closer to the end time. We particularly noted that this is a time that is quite challenging. Even though it's quite challenging, God gave us an admonition that our lives should not be scattered and we should not be drunken, and that our portion should not be that of surfeiting. And in a nutshell, we looked at what drunkenness and surfeiting meant.
That
actually it is not the act of taking a bottle of beer and gulping it down and then developing stupor. But we were looking at the end point of drunkenness or drinking. And we saw that the byproduct is actually depression. That after somebody has allowed himself to be given to drunkenness, the person loses motivation. The person loses his zeal and the strength that should be in him. And that person becomes despondent, discouraged, and sunken into his
seat.
And we did say that this is the condition and situation in the lives of so many today. Many are despondent, Many are depressed. Suicide rate is even going up by the day. People are jumping into rivers and drinking chemicals as it
goes.
And some of this frustration does not even insulate Christians. Christians are not insulated
with
them. But God is telling us. He has forewarned us in the book of Luke chapter 21. That we should not be given to surfeiting and drunkenness. The scripture even told us to take heed. And if there is no danger ahead, the word take heed does not have a place. So our God that knows the beginning from the end has seen the situation that we are in now. Has seen the situation that you are in now. Has seen what is happening to the world today. And is telling us to take heed. What a great time that this is coming to pass. And haven't challenged ourselves that way. We now said that one of the ways by which you can stand and stand strong at this time is that you should have a mindset to redeem the time. Which we saw in the book of Ephesians chapter 5. That God admonishing us to redeem the time for the place of our evil. God also admonish us not to be idle in the marketplace of life. That many are going to be so discouraged as to be bereft of even what to do now. Ideas can has a potential of dying in the hearts of so many because of the time we are
in.
The health of some people have capability to fail even at this time. And so we did say that God is challenging every one of us that this is not a time to be idle. That the Lord Jesus Christ is coming soon. And surely he will come. But at this particular point in time that he has not come, we should occupy till that time comes. And then God led us to begin to look at six practical steps that we should take as a habit at this point in time. You remember that the first step that we said was that we should daily cultivate the habit of staying under his shadow. And we use Psalm 91 as our reference point. And we did say that every man that abide under the shadow of the Almighty God, we have three principal things that God will do to him. The first one is protection. That person, irrespective of what is happening around, irrespective of whether 1,000 is falling on the right side or 10,000 by the right side, it is with his eyes that he will be seeing them. So it's also going to give us the benefit of incubation. When you stay under the shadow of the Almighty God, you enjoy incubation for your life. As a chicken incubates upon her children, that's how God will incubate on you. Ideas that you never knew that will become reality. If you make it a duty to abide under the shadow of the Almighty, they will begin to unfold before your eyes. The third thing that we did say that you benefit is that you will continually have inspiration. Ideas will just suddenly be jumping into your heart. God will just suddenly be bringing things that are not as if they were to you. So all this will meet you where you abide under
His
shadow. The second thing that God advertised to us is that we must have another spirit. That we must not call what they call conspiracy. And we must not fear their fears. As Isaiah 8:12 has told us, that we should have another spirit. That our heart should be like the heart of the psalmist. When he said in the book of Psalm 41 verse 1, that my heart is indicting a good matter. In spite of the challenges that was confronting David at that time, he said my heart was indicting in a good matter. God knows what is happening now, but he's the one who is also challenging you now. Let new song begin to who's out of your heart. Let new thoughts begin to who's out of your mouth. And we went to see the life of Caleb. Caleb was our character study at the first edition. Briefly, we saw when Moses asked the children, the leaders of the children of Israel, to spy the promised land. We saw that of all of them that went to spy the land, mind you, they were heads of their clans. Mind you, they were of the same blood and
genera.
But they didn't bring the same report.
All
of them bring the reports of sadness. All of them brought the reports that can make a man to fall down and die. But it took the hearts of two men to stand out. And that was the heart that Caleb had. That was the heart that Joshua had. They had a different perception. And we did say that there is nothing wrong with what you are seeing. What is wrong is the eyes with which you are seeing. Caleb had a different eye. So where people are seeing problems, Caleb was seeing solution. Where people, his brethren, were seeing difficulties, where his brethren were seeing the anarch in the land, brother Caleb was seeing possibilities. He was seeing triumph and success and victory. And we concluded at that edition that all of us should begin to pray that the Lord should give us a different spirit. That the Lord should change our heart. The Lord said that Caleb had a different spirit and he followed God fully. And we are at, God was admonishing us that we should pray so that we can have a different spirit in this challenging time. So in this second part of the message, we are going further with the remaining steps that we ought to take at the time like this. And today we'll be starting with talking about step number 3. That at a time like this, it's a time to keep the bond of fellowship. A lot of people may look around today and say that how do we fellowship? But because of the prevailing circumstances. But I dare tell you that it is in difficulty that God expects the church of God to move forward. Oftentimes when I read the Bible, and there is a difficult challenge at every point point in time, after that challenge that has faced the church or the fellowship, I often heard the word and the church of God move forward. And more people were added to the church. And I said that this period should not be an exception. Do you know that as I'm speaking now, I remember a little bit of what's happening in communist China. Before the church was fully banned, fellowship was banned fully, and there was something like a death sentence upon anybody that infringes upon it, the number of Christians in communist China, they were not up to 1 million. It was in the process of the lockdown of the church. Even though the church operates undercover significantly, but you now have more than hundreds of millions of people who are belonging to fellowship. So it is in a period of challenge that God wants to show himself mighty upon the church. So as an individual, this is a time to keep the bond of fellowship. Let's see what Psalm 133 says about this. Psalm
133.
Hallelujah. He said, behold how good and how pleasant. God is saying how good and how pleasant. Irrespective of the situation that we are going through now, God is saying fellowship is sweet and pleasant. And how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. We may not be able to physically connect with each other, but we can fellowship with ourselves in the spirit. We must not get out of fellowship. He said it is pleasant for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard that went down to the skirt of his garment. And the second stanza of verse 3. He said, for dear the Lord commanded the blessing, even life forevermore. If there is anywhere God commands his blessing, it is in fellowship. If there is anywhere that progress is embedded, is in fellowship. If there is any time or anywhere that brethren can record progress in their lives, it is in fellowship. It is in fellowship that you will have spiritual growth. It is in fellowship that you will have occupational growth. As a matter of fact, the Bible says that the church of God is the ground and the pillar of truth. In 1 Timothy chapter 3 verse 15, Paul was writing to Timothy. He said that you may know how to behave in the household of God, which is the ground and pillar of the truth. The church of God, fellowship, is the ground and pillar of truth. What is pillar, brethren? pillar is the sustainer. The strength of a house is incumbent on the strength of the pillar that it has.
Bi ile yo duwa yo wolu de o ni se pelu awon opo to gbero.
So if you have a house that have very strong pillar, that house, the possibility is that it's going to stay long.
Ta ba wa ri awon ile ti akon ti opo re do giri o tumo si bi pe ile na yo pe lori duro.
Brethren, so if your life is going to stay long and strong for a very long time against the tide of the times, it must be in fellowship.
Ara nitori na ti aye re yo ba duro tiri ti o la awon isoro ati ijikoja o gbodo duro ninu isopo pelu awon ara.
If that idea that God gives you has to be an idea that will transcend now, it has to be bathed in fellowship.
To ba je pe oye ti a fi fun o ti olorun mu to wa ni ti o ba so eso rere ti o pe titi a ni lati bi ninu isopo pelu awon ara.
And the Bible also says that it is the ground of the truth.
Bible to have the mule pe ohun ni ipile otito.
So whatever you plant in fellowship,
onko pa wa pe ninu isopo
has a capacity to grow and to blossom.
O ni ase lati dagba, lati gboro, lati ruwe, lati gberu.
A marriage that is planted in fellowship,
igbeyawo ti o fori sole ninu isopo awon ara,
has a capacity to grow and fulfill divine purpose.
O ni ase lati gbara, lati dagba, lati gboro, lati mu ife Olorun fun
ile na se. There's a saying that our parents used to say in those days about marriage.
Nipa igbeyawo awon obi wa ma so nkan fun wa nigba na.
They will tell us that iyawo ta ba fe loju ijo, ijo lo nba lo.
They were telling us that a wife married at the place of entertainment, we go with celebration.
Iyawo ta ba fe loju oti, oti lo nba lo.
A wife married at the point of drunkenness, we go in such a way.
Because all those grounds, they are shifting grounds.
Nitori awon igbe ipile ni won je ipile to ma nsipo pada.
Because all those grounds are shifting grounds.
Nitori awon ipile ni won ma nsipo pada.
So I say to you, young man,
arakunrin mo so fun ojo
wa, can you be in fellowship?
Njo le wa ninu idapo pelu
awon ara. Can you submit that thing to fellowship?
Njo le yonda ko gbe kale fun awon ara.
And somebody may be asking, what is fellowship?
Enikan le ma wa bere pe kini idapo awon ara.
Fellowship is the flow of one believer into another under Christ.
Isopo awon ara tumo si bi pe shinso ninu aye arakunrin si arakunrin koji ninu ife Christi.
Flowing into you and you flowing into me under Christ.
Ki emi ma san sinu re ki iwo ma san sinu mi ninu Christi.
So young man,
arakunrin,
can you submit that your proposal to fellowship?
Awon eromba re ni jo le pe kale ninu isopo pelu awon ara.
I see some young people,
mo ri awon odo kan,
when it is time for them to marry,
to ba to ikorita igbeyawo,
that is when the counter set of their head will scatter.
Nigba na ni koko ori won yo daru.
That is when you see them running away from fellowship.
Nigba na ni won sa lo ko laarin awon ara.
That is when they despise fellowship.
Nigba na ni won kegun awon isopo ara.
What concern pastor with my life?
Kini ti pastor ni se pelu igbeyawo temi?
What have I seen not married this soul?
Se ko ti ife yawo ti eni?
And I do tell them,
but the man so fun,
is pastor going to marry two wives?
Iya pastor yo ba fe yawo meji.
If it is in another place, I don't know.
To ba je ni bomira o le so.
But here,
sugbon nibi,
there is no pastor.
Ko si pa oluse
ku ta. There is no elder.
Ko si adari kankan.
That is proposing.
To gbiyanju.
Or has the capacity.
Abi to ni lokan.
Or has the audacity.
Abi to ni ase.
To say he want to marry another wife.
To ni ogboju la so pe won fe yawo.
So what is your own?
Ewo wa nti e.
They just want your life to be correct in fellowship.
Aye re la fe to.
They want your life to be correct in fellowship.
A se ki aye re ko to ni.
You say this process is too cumbersome.
Owa ni gbogbo igbekale won yo ti gunju.
They are asking me for my testimony.
Won bere eri mi.
They are asking me to come day and night and be having counseling.
Laaro osun ale no ni ki ma wa ko ma gba mi imoran.
I will go out and do it and come back.
Won lo se tin se ti ba se ton pada wa.
You are standing on a shifting ground.
O n duro lori ipile ti ko ni duro.
Because it is in fellowship that God commands his blessing.
Nitori ninu isopo pelu awon adajo Oluwa pase ibukun.
Do you know what amuses me about the church?
Ijo to ma n ja mi lenu pa ijo.
The church is a place where you can be tolerated.
Ijo je ibi to je pe a le faye gba o.
It is a ground where tolerance abides.
O je ibi ti a ti faye gba oniruuru.
In the church,
ninu ijo,
at best they will excuse you. They will excuse themselves from you.
Ni to buru ju mele pe kon yan kon kon sa fun o.
They will not even ask you to go out.
Won ti e ni le o pe ma wa jo
si. I've hardly seen churches where they say, or fellowship, they say, don't come here again.
Mi o sa sa ni ile ijosin At best,
they tolerate you.
What
they would have flogged you outside. What you would have gone to prison for outside. Inside fellowship, they tolerate you. What you would have said, and people would say, eh? Don't come and say this thing again. You will come and say it in fellowship. And somebody will say, Brother Boye,
and
God will help you. Ordinarily, if you do that in your office, you will be sacked. You will collect
query.
But fellowship will tolerate you.
It's
a grant for tolerance. Fellowship
is support.
It's a place where God can nurture you. For you to become what you want to become in life. Does it not amuse you today? That even men that are doing greatly in the secular world. You know, anytime I read motivational speakers, I listen to them, or I read their books. You don't need to have revelation to have an idea that these people are product of the church. When I see people who are dexterous in handling one equipment or the other, and they are using it to make money and wrong fame for themselves instead of Jesus. When I look at it, I will find out that that boy was groomed in fellowship. I don't want to call the name of a musician in Nigeria. He was somebody that played music well. And took a lot of people, unless God helps them, to help. His father was a church leader. Because he was trained in fellowship. Young, can you be trained in fellowship? Can you be trained how to speak in fellowship? Can you be trained how to relate to people in fellowship? Can you be trained how to keep quiet in fellowship? So don't despise fellowship, because that is where the blessing of God is. It is in fellowship, brethren, that God is looking for you to engage in what I call strategic partnering. When you are in fellowship, what you actually need in life. You know, a reality dawn on me sometimes. That actually the church of God is sufficient in itself. All I need is in the church. All you need is in fellowship. You only need to unbundle yourself. You only need to flow into another person in Christ. And that thing will be done. You remember the story of Peter and his brothers in Luke chapter 5. 5:7. When the Lord had finished using their boats, and Jesus said they should cast their nets into the sea. Nets that had not caught anything before. And as they threw it there, they caught hordes of fishes. And their net was almost breaking. Do you know what they did? They bound on their brethren. Fellowship is a place for strategic engagement. Brethren, if you need an advisory service, be immersed in fellowship.
sopọ sinu isopọ pẹlu
awọn. Do you know that many of the talk that they give us.
Njẹ a mọ pe pupọ ni awọn ọrọ to n sọ fun wa.
If you go to the people of the world to give you.
Tọ́ bá lọ sí àdó àwọn ènìyàn ìta lọ́hun láti lọ gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀
yìí. Do you know how much you are going to pay for it.
Jo mọ iye owó tó sọ kó tó wọlé.
Sometimes they will even swindle you.
Nígbà míì wọ́n tún bá ọ.
But here you have it in fellowship.
Níbí ọkàn balẹ̀ àárín àwọn
aráàlú. Do you know that the counsel that God gives you through people in fellowship.
Ìjọba pé ìmọ̀ràn tí Ọlọ́run fún ọ nípa ìsopọ̀ pẹ̀lú àwọn ará.
If you are to search for it elsewhere you pay.
Tó bá jẹ́ pé níbòmíràn ni ó níye tó san.
You will not only pay with your money, you pay with your body.
Ó sanwó lára owó tún fara san. Ó fowó san.
But fellowship is a place for free of all that.
Ṣùgbọ́n ìsopọ̀ pẹ̀lú àwọn ará ó jẹ́ ọ̀fẹ́.
And if at this end time brethren.
Tó bá jẹ́ ní àkókò òpin ayé bí
ènìyàn. If we are going to triumph at this end time.
Tá ò bá ṣẹ́gun ní àkókò yìí.
We must begin to value fellowship.
A gbọ́dọ̀ máa mú fellowship ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú àwọn ará ní òkúnkúndùn.
And when we say we value fellowship.
Tá a bá ní amú ní òkúnkúndùn.
You must begin to eschew what breaks fellowship.
A gbọ́dọ̀ kíyèsí ara ká yẹra fún ohun tó ń mú ìyapa bá ìsopọ̀ pẹ̀lú àwọn.
What makes my brother to feel uncomfortable with me, I must avoid it in fellowship.
Ohun tí ò ní jẹ́ kí àwọn ará kan ní ìrọ̀rùn pẹ̀lú mi, mo gbọ́dọ̀ yẹra fún.
You know everybody is carrying in a way a saw in his body, literally.
Ǹjẹ́ àwọn pé gbogbo wa pátá la ní ọgbẹ́ tí à ń gbé ní ara wa gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹnìkan.
And what happens when you see somebody marching on your saw?
Nígbà báwo ló ṣe máa wá rí tó bá rí ẹnìkan tó ń tẹ ọgbẹ́ rẹ mọ́lẹ̀.
That person, you will not be properly connected with him.
Nítòótọ́ irú ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ kò tiẹ̀ ní jẹ́ni tó wà fẹ́ súnmọ́.
Because he does not watch what you are doing.
Torí kò tiẹ̀ kíyèsí ohun tó ń ṣe.
There are several ways where we can break fellowship.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ọ̀nà láti lè gbà mú kí ìyapa kó bá
ìtọ́sí. You know some people will borrow. The Bible says the wicked borrows and he doesn't pay back.
Ìjọba ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ló máa yá. Bíbélì wípé ènìyàn búburú ó yá kò sì san padà.
You borrow money from a brethren.
Ó yá owó lọ́wọ́ arákùnrin rẹ.
And you didn't pay back.
O dẹ̀ san padà ní àkókò.
And you are coming to sit down with him in fellowship.
Ẹ dẹ̀ tí wá jọ ń jókòó wojú ara yín nínú ìjọsìn.
Maybe you are even the one giving revelation in the fellowship.
Bóyá àwọn gangan tún náà lásọtẹ́lẹ̀ nínú ìdílé ìjọsìn náà.
That brother is disconnected from you.
Pẹ̀lú gbogbo àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ rẹ níwájú arákùnrin ọ̀hún.
Don't make him an hypocrite.
Má sọ ọ́ di alájàbàgebè.
Go and pay.
Lọ san gbèsè rẹ.
Go and give what you promise you want to give him to
him. Ìlérí tó ṣe ẹ̀jẹ̀ tó jẹ́ lọ mú ṣẹ.
Don't break confidence.
Má jẹ́ kí àwọn èèyàn kan ti pa ara rẹ kọsẹ̀.
When they have told you something in secret.
Nígbà tí wọ́n bá ti sọ nǹkan fún ọ ní àṣírí.
Don't go and be bearing tale about it outside.
Má wàá sọ ju ohun tó máa sọ lórí òrùlé.
When they have told you something in your house.
Nígbà tí wọ́n sọ nǹkan fún ọ nínú ilé.
Don't let it be that when you get to fellowship.
Má jẹ́ kó jẹ́ pé bàtọ́ bá wá dé àárín àwọn ẹgbẹ́.
That is when you now spread it before everybody.
Nígbà náà ló wà tẹ́pẹpẹ àṣírí aláṣírí
láàrin. I see you breaking fellowship.
Mo rí ọ tó bá ń ṣerú eléyìí gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹni tó ń mú kí ìyapa kó bá ìjọsìn.
And if you are one of those people.
Tó bá jẹ́ ọ̀kan nínú àwọn tó ń ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀.
Who is doing that?
Tó ń ṣerú èyí.
Can you repent?
Ǹjẹ́ o lè ronú pìwàdà?
Because this is the time that we should hold for strong the bond of fellowship.
Nítorí àkókò rè fún wa láti mú kí ìsopọ̀ àwọn ará kó le koko.
Do you know that we are in a time now.
Ǹjẹ́ o mọ̀ pé àkókò rè.
In fellowship when we must flow into each other.
Tí a gbọ́dọ̀ sàn sínú ara wa.
Do you know that it is not a time to go solo?
O mọ̀ pé àkókò kọ́ rè fún ọ láti máa dárìn.
It is not a time for you to have a thing and keep it to yourself.
Kí ni àkókò fún ọ láti ní nǹkan pa kó sọ àpá ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ
nìkan? Because what made the church of God thick ab initio or in the hearts of apostles was because of strong fellowship.
Ní tó mú kí ìjọ Ọlọ́run kó dàgbà kó nípọn ní ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ òun ni pé wọ́n ní ìsopọ̀ láàrin
àwọn ará. So what is the practical application of that?
Kí wá ni kókó ìsopọ̀ wa?
If my brother has land.
Tí arákùnrin mi bá ní ilẹ̀.
And me, I don't have land.
Èmi ò sì ní ilẹ̀.
But I have money.
Ṣùgbọ́n mo ní owó.
And my brother does not have money.
Arákùnrin mi ò sì ní owó.
And the third and we need somebody who has idea.
Àwa nílò ẹnìkan tó ní òye.
In that particular thing.
Nínú nǹkan wọ̀nyí.
What God wants us to be doing.
Ohun tí Ọlọ́run retí kí a máa ṣe.
A man who has money.
Ẹni tó ní owó.
Make your help available to the brother that has land.
Jẹ́ ṣe ìrànlọ́wọ́ fún arákùnrin tó ní ilẹ̀.
Incorporate the brother that has idea.
Mú arákùnrin tó ní òye ni.
Without anybody feeling disadvantaged or superior to one another.
Of course,
what did we have that we didn't receive? So
we
are expected to flow into each other so that we can all flock together. You know, sometimes when I move around and I get to some places and I see some investment and they say, it is these people that have this investment. The people of other religions, this is their investment. This is the project that they are jointly undertaking. I say, what are my brethren doing? We that knows the essence of fellowship and it was committed to us by God. So this crucial time is a time for us to strategically flow into fellowship so that everybody at this end time will have need for nothing. So we have emphasized the bond of fellowship. And I dare also say to you, brethren, that it is also time for individuals to begin to trust God for where to flow into. I believe I'm also talking to some group of professionals that are listening to me. Flow into a professional fellowship. If you are an architect and there is a professional group that you know that this group is a place where ideas under God can be shared, flow into it. You know the Bible says my people perish for lack of knowledge. You have associations that are not antichrist around.
Flow
into it. You are a business professional. There are several business professional groups around. It is time for you to pray. God, I want to take advantage of this. There is a lot that you gain from that. Even as you are in the fellowship with your fellow brethren. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The fourth thing that you have to do at this time is to embark ceaselessly in value development. Is to develop in self-value development. I want you to be aware that the world is changing. And you cannot be stagnant in a moving world. Even the devil is dynamic in his machination. Okay, let me explain better. There is nothing new under heaven. I was telling some people, I said everything you see done now that people are using to do 419 for themselves, it has been before. Do you know at that time, we used to have a place called Woroluwole in Lagos.
There is a place they call Woroluwole Leko.
There is nothing you take there that they cannot falsify. Even if you bring it from Norway, Denmark, US, they will falsify it for you. Oyibos had to come to Woroluwole. International reports has to show that this is one of the scam points in the world. And we had people at that time that were tools in the hand of the devil that time. Have you seen where the 419 somebody, they took him to a whole ship with consignment inside? For those who are about maybe 50 years and above, we know what I'm talking about. And when the person wanted to go and take possession of the consignment, do you know what happened? It was
419.
In fact, I learned that person died after.
So it is the same seed of the devil that has now metamorphosed now. It has now become the Yahoo Yahoo. It has become a Baba Jebu or whatever. It has now gone sophisticated with the world. So if the devil is so dynamic, the church cannot afford to be stagnant. Because if we are stagnant in a moving world, you are not even stagnant, rather you are going backwards. And how will we be able to cope at this time?
It's
when individual brethren in the church begin to seek the face of God for perspectives in self-development. Under God, you begin to look for avenues to grow yourself. And how can you grow yourself
in it?
One of the ways by which you can grow yourself is to look for what to read. I have seen brethren who have been born again for 10 years. They have not read two Christian books. I have seen brethren who have graduated from university 10 years ago. They have not added anything to their certificate. No single training has been added to it. No book have they read. They are eating
that bush meat of last year and their meat.
How can you be a person of value, that an instrument of revival in this time? You know, there are some times that when God gives you a window, and that window, if you have not measured up to it in your closet, you will be disqualified. You will not be able to maximize it. What am I saying today? Am I challenging a young person here? I tell young people, I'm not
sure.
You watch one soap opera for 3 hours. 3 hours is gone out of 24 hours. You say, film we do. You watch another 6 hours is gone out of 24 hours. So what is now left for you? And do you remember, as I used to tell people, he who stays long on the television will never be on the television.
And again, it's about
television. Because people who do what you are watching, they create time to study and soil and build themselves in the closet. You delight in watching football. Do I say football watching is not good? But I'm saying, don't let your passion be incumbent on it. For you to be a person that God wants at this time, you cannot afford to finish all your time on television. You have not even read a chapter of the Bible. But you know all the names of the footballers and their transfer fees. You don't have food in your stomach. As God, what is that very good footballer? Cristiano Ronaldo. And Messi. As they are performing their goal in life, you are watching them. Let me tell you what I read sometimes. That book identified 4 people. He said the first person, there are people who don't see vision at all. And they are walking around on the surface of the
earth.
That book called them wanderers. They are wanderers. There is nothing they are pursuing. He said the second stage of people, they are people that actually
see vision.
Àwọn làwọn tó máa rí ìran.
But they don't pursue it.
Wọn kì í lẹ́pa ìran náà.
So those people, they call them followers.
A máa ń pè wọ́n ní atẹ̀lé ni lẹ́yìn.
Other people will be the one leading them.
Àwọn èèyàn ló máa lọ tó máa tẹ̀lé wọn lẹ́yìn.
They will say we have accepted our own destiny.
Wọ́n ní àwọn ti gba ìpín tàwọn.
This is how God said we should be.
Bọ́lá ń ṣe ní káwọn orí rèé.
And there are plenty on the surface of the earth.
Ó dẹ̀ pọ̀ lórí ilé alàyè.
Even there are plenty in the church.
Wọ́n tiẹ̀ tún pọ̀ nínú ìjọsìn.
And that book identified the third category.
Ìwé náà sọ fún nípa àwọn ìpele kẹrin.
He said there are people who see vision.
Àwọn ìpele kẹta ìwọ́n rí ìran.
And who are pursuing it.
Wọ́n dẹ̀ ń lépa rẹ̀.
They call them achievers.
À ń pè wọ́n ní aláṣeyọrí.
They are the people you call achievers.
Àwọn là ń pè ní aláṣeyọrí.
But I was not excited about that.
Ṣùgbọ́n gbogbo àwọn wọ̀nyí kò tiẹ̀ mú.
I was excited about the fourth category.
Èyí tó dùn mọ́ mi jùlọ ni àwọn ìpele kẹrin ni.
They said these people.
Wọ́n ní àwọn wọ̀nyí.
They see vision.
Wọ́n rí ìran.
They pursue the vision.
Wọ́n lépa ìran náà.
They now carry people along inside the vision.
Wọ́n tún gbé àwọn èèyàn mú rọwọ́nú ìlépa wọn náà.
That is what God is calling you to.
Eléyìí ni ìpè Ọlọ́run fún ayé rẹ o.
That is what God is calling you to.
Eléyìí ni Ọlọ́run pè ọ́ pé kò jẹ́.
So brethren, I challenge you today.
Ara mo pè ọ́ níjà lónìí.
I challenge you.
Mo pè ọ́ níjà.
Look at what Paul said to Timothy.
Wo ohun tí Paul sọ fún Timothy.
In 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 13.
Nínú ìwé Timothy kejì orí kẹrin.
He says study to show thyself approved.
Ó ní ṣe takuntakun láti rí pé o ní ìdánilẹ́kọ̀ọ́. Láti jẹ́ ìtẹ̀wọ́gbà.
Study.
Ṣe ìdánilẹ́kọ̀ọ́.
Tarry at it.
Jókòó tí.
Take the Bible.
Ka Bíbélì, mú Bíbélì.
Read it.
Ka.
Study it.
Ka dáadáa.
Ponder on it.
Máa ṣàṣàrò nínú rẹ̀.
Take books.
Ka ìwé.
Do you know that if you read a book.
Ǹjẹ́ ọ̀pẹ tó bá ka ìwé kan.
About a man who is 70 years old.
Nípa ọkùnrin kan tó ti lé ní 90 ọdún.
And you are 30 years old.
Wọ́n dẹ̀ jẹ́ ọmọ 90 ọdún.
And you are able to finish that man's book.
Tó wá parí ìwé tí ọmọ ẹni 90 ọdún.
All the rising and falling of that man for 70 years.
Gbogbo ìdìde àti ìṣubú rẹ̀ fún 90 ọdún ni.
You have added it to your own life in less than 2 weeks.
O ti fi kún ayé ìrírí ayé tirẹ̀ láàrin ọ̀sẹ̀ méjì.
So when anybody is seeing you.
Tẹ́nikẹ́ni bá wá ń rí ọ.
And they say, ah, look at this 30-year-old boy.
Wọ́n máa ní máa wọ ọmọ ọgbọ̀n ọdún yìí.
But in actual sense, how many years are you?
Ṣùgbọ́n ní òye ní tòótọ́ ọmọ ọdún mélòó ni ọ.
It's 30 years plus 70 years.
O ti ní òye ẹni ọgbọ̀n ọdún pẹ̀lú 90 ọdún.
Your chronological age may be 30.
Lóòótọ́ ọjọ́ orí rẹ tí a ń kà nígbà tàbí ó lè jẹ ọgbọ̀n ọdún.
But your real age in value is 100 years.
Ṣùgbọ́n ojúlówó iye bí iye ọjọ́ orí rẹ o ti tó ọgọ́
ọdún. I see many young men like that.
Mo rí ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ọ̀dọ́ bẹ́ẹ̀.
You know some of us that are not seeing properly.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wọn tá ò rí dáadáa.
They say, hey, keep short.
Wọ́n ní pẹ̀lúmọ́.
Lis ten to the elders.
Máa gbọ́ máa kétí sí àwọn àlàgbà.
What is the worth of an elder that has not garbage value to his life?
Kí ni kókó àti kí ni iye alàgbà tí ò ní nǹkan àgbà nínú ọjọ́ ní ọpọlọ.
Like one of my children told me one day.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìkànnì àwọn ọmọ mi ṣe sọ mí lọ́jọ́ kan.
He said it is not every alàgbà that is alàgbà. I am just paraphrasing.
He is just saying that not elderly people are actually elders.
Because we should be looking at what an elder is or a leader is or somebody is by virtue of the value and content inside of him.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ a máa wo alàgbà gẹ́gẹ́ bí alàgbà nípa kì í ṣe ọjọ́ orí bí kò ṣe ohun tó gbé ohun tó ní àti òye ìgbékalẹ̀ rẹ̀.
So a 25-year-old man.
Nítorí náà ọmọ ọgbọ̀n ọdún.
Who has had 15 years work with God.
Tó ti bá Ọlọ́run rìn fọdún mẹ́ẹ̀ẹ́dógún.
And you now have a 50-year-old man.
O wá rí ọmọ 50 ọdún kan.
Who has just had 3 years old with the Lord. With the Lord.
Tó kàn tiẹ̀ bá Ọlọ́run fún ọdún mẹ́ta péré.
And you want to judge the two of them.
O wá fẹ́ fi àwọn méjèèjì fẹ́ fi wọ́n gbẹ.
He says small boy go and sit down.
Pé ọ̀dọ́mọkùnrin lọ́jọ́kọ.
He may be small in age.
Lójó orí ó lè má dàgbà.
But he's big in content.
Ṣùgbọ́n nínú ohun tó jẹ́.
So I was so surprised going through the scripture. We don't have time.
Ó yà mí lẹ́nu nígbà tí mo wo ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
I saw that Apostle Paul.
Mo rí pé Paul apostle.
Some of the secrets of his weighty exploit in God.
Gbogbo àwọn àṣírí ìjìnlẹ̀ àṣeyọrí rẹ̀ nínú Ọlọ́run.
Was because he added value into his life in the area of studiousness.
Nítorí pé ó fi kún ayé rẹ̀ jẹ́ iyebíye.
Apart from telling Timothy.
Yàtọ̀ sí kó sọ fún Timothy.
That he should study to be approved.
Pé kó sa ipá rẹ̀.
láti rí pé òun kú ojú òṣùwọ̀n nínú ẹ̀kọ́.
You know when he was writing a letter to him again.
Nígbà tó tún kọ letter mìíràn sí.
He wrote to him that he should not forget his parchment and his books.
Ó ní má gbàgbé àwọn ìwé àti àwọn àkọsílẹ̀ mi ni.
So one of the things that Apostle Paul valued.
Àwọn nǹkan tó ṣeyebíye fún Paul apostoli.
Were his books.
Àwọn ìwé rẹ ni.
You are sitting down there.
Ìwọ jókòó síbẹ̀.
You want to get revelation from God.
O fẹ́ ní òye láti ọ̀dọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
You are a civil servant.
O jẹ́ òṣìṣẹ́ ìjọba.
You are an employee.
O jẹ́ ẹni tó ń gbani síṣẹ́.
Since you have been working, àgbọ̀nrín èsì ìmọ̀ yẹn ló ṣì ń jẹ lọ́bẹ̀.
Látijọ́ tó o ti ń ṣiṣẹ́, you have never added value to yourself.
I said they didn't promote me.
Gbẹ́gbà tí wọ́n gbé mi sókè.
Kí ni nǹkan tuntun tó o mú wá léṣẹ́?
What have you added to your place of work?
Don't come and pray against them as devil here.
Má wá síbí, má wá gbàdúrà bíi pé ṣù ni wọ́n níbí.
They are not devils.
Wọ́n ń ṣe èṣù.
You should go and work on your own life.
Ìwọ ni kò ṣiṣẹ́ sórí ayé.
Go and bend down to add more value.
Bẹ̀rẹ̀ kó fi kún ayé rẹ.
We have been at home for some time now.
A ti wà nílé fún àwọn ọjọ́ kan.
There are free things online.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ nǹkan ló jẹ́ lọ́fẹ̀ẹ́ lórí
ayé. Free training online.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìdánilẹ́kọ̀ọ́ lórí ayé.
Free books online.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìwé lọ́fẹ̀ẹ́ lórí
ayé. Somebody said, particularly in this our country Nigeria.
Pàápàá jùlọ lórílẹ̀-èdè Nàìjíríà wa ẹnìkan sọ pé.
He said if you want Nigeria not to see something.
Pé tó o bá fẹ́ pa nǹkan kan mọ́ kò lójú àwọn ará
Nàìjíríà. Go and hide it in a book.
Lọ kọ́ sínú ìwé.
Brethren,
ara,
I want to challenge you today.
Mo fẹ́ pè ọ́ níjà lónìí.
God is wanting you to have self-value development.
Ọlọ́run fẹ́ kó o mú ara rẹ dàgbà.
Break away from stereotypes.
Kúrò nínú ìdádúró tiri ni.
Study to self approved.
Làkàkà kò ṣe ṣàìpá rẹ láti kà láti
tẹ̀síwájú. So that you can have good perspective about issues.
Kó o lè ní òye ẹ̀kúnrẹ́rẹ́ nípa àwọn ohun tó bá ń ṣe.
So that your prophecy can be precise.
Kí àwọn àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ rẹ kó lè jẹ́ ẹ̀kúnrẹ́rẹ́ ojúlówó.
You know there are some prophecies that are not foundated on God through correct inspiration.
A ti mọ̀ wípé a mọ̀ pé ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ ló wà tí ò ní ìpìlẹ̀ rẹ̀ lórí ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ní kókó rẹ̀.
Because when you look at it.
Nígbà tó bá wò dáadáa.
There is no weight to it.
Kò tiẹ̀ ní kò ó fúyẹ́.
There is nothing inside.
Kò tiẹ̀ kò wúwo rárá.
Even some of us we come and preach self.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ló yóò tẹ̀ wá wá wàásù gbà mí.
And when you are preaching.
Nígbà tó wá ń gbà tó ń wàásù.
People are just tolerating you.
Àwọn èèyàn kan sáà ń fara dà fún ọ.
Because what you are giving them.
Orí tó ń fún wọn jẹ.
They know that it's not correct.
Wọ́n mọ̀ pé kò tọ́.
Do you know that this time is even a time for us to take this matter seriously?
Ǹjẹ́ mọ̀ pé àkókò ni láti wá mú ní òkùnkùn dùn.
One day.
Lọ́jọ́ kan.
I was saying something somewhere.
Mo ń sọ nǹkan kan níbi kan.
Me, I was just talking.
Èmi kan tẹ̀ ń bá àwọn èèyàn kan sọ̀rọ̀.
In the evening of that day.
Ní ìrọ̀lẹ́ ọjọ́ náà.
Somebody now called me and said I should sit down.
Ẹnìkan wá pè mí pé jókòó síbẹ̀ yẹn.
He said when you were talking in the morning.
Nígbà tó ń bá wa sọ̀rọ̀ láàárọ̀.
You said something.
Ó sọ kankan.
And immediately I took my phone.
Ní kété tí mo wá yẹ fóònù
mi wò. I began to verify what you said.
Mo wá bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní ṣe òfintó tó ń kó o sọ.
God save you that it was correct.
Ọlọ́run yọ tó jẹ́ pé òótọ́ ló sọ.
I laughed over it.
Mo rẹ́rìn-ín.
But from that day.
Ṣùgbọ́n láti ọjọ́ náà.
I began to follow the rules that we used to do when I was a journalist.
Mo wá bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní tẹ̀lé àwọn ìlànà àti òfin. Gẹ́gẹ́ bí akọ́ṣẹ́mọṣẹ́ oníròyìn.
If in doubt, leave out.
Tó bá ti jẹ́ pé kò ń ṣiyè méjì ń parẹ̀ yọ̀ǹda rẹ̀.
For our leadership to be effective.
Fún ìdarí wa láti jẹ́ ojúlówó.
We must be persons of value.
A gbọ́dọ̀ jẹ́ ẹni tó ní iye lórí.
For our followership to be effective.
Fún àwọn ènìyàn gidi láti tẹ̀lé wa.
You must be a person of value.
O gbọ́dọ̀ jẹ́ ẹni tó ní jẹ́ ṣe iyebíye.
You know you will be a good brethren in the church.
O jẹ́ arákùnrin tó dára nínú ìjọsìn.
If God grants you understanding.
Tí Ọlọ́run bá fún ọ ní òye.
If a man of understanding.
Tó bá jẹ́ ènìyàn tó lóye.
You know Daniel said.
Daniel bi pe.
That he saw vision.
Pé ó rí ìran.
By the books that were written about it.
Nípa àwọn ohun tí a ti kọ sílẹ̀ síwájú.
So he was a man that was not just a prophet.
Kì í kàn ṣe wòlíì tó ń sọ tẹ́lẹ̀ nìkan.
He was a prophet that diligently seeks the books.
Ó jẹ́ wòlíì tó tún máa ń ṣe àwọn ìtọpinpin àwọn àkọsílẹ̀ ni.
So brethren, God is challenging us.
Ara Ọlọ́run pè wọ́n níjà.
And it is one of those things that we must do.
Ó dẹ̀ jẹ́ ọ̀kan náà àwọn ohun tá a gbọ́dọ̀ ṣe.
You must also begin to company with people that God has helped.
O gbọ́dọ̀ máa fara kínra pẹ̀lú àwọn tí Ọlọ́run ti ràn lọ́wọ́.
Because in them we flow into your own life value and virtue.
Nítorí nínú wọn, wọ́n sàn sínú rẹ iyebíye àti àwọn tó ṣe ojúlówó.
So because of our time.
Nítorí àkókò wa.
Another step.
step that you must begin to watch out for at this time.
Àwọn ohun tó gbọ́dọ̀ tún máa kíyèsí ní àkókò yìí.
Is to trust God to live a life of prudence.
Òun láti gbà kó gba Ọlọ́run gbọ́ láti gbé ìgbé ayé.
You acknowledge that things are getting difficult.
Àmọ̀ ó mọ̀ wípé ohun gbogbo ló ń ṣòro
tí wọ́n ṣe. And His grace is sufficient for us.
Orí ọ̀fẹ́ rẹ̀ ó dẹ̀ tó fún ọ.
But for us to be able to navigate this time.
Ṣùgbọ́n fún ọ láti la àkókò yìí kọjá.
We must trust God.
A gbọ́dọ̀ gba Ọlọ́run gbọ́.
To begin to live lives of prudence.
A gbọ́dọ̀ kọ́ láti máa gbé ìgbé ayé tó jẹ́
ojúlówó. Be slothful in business.
Má ṣe ṣe ìmẹ́lẹ́ nínú iṣẹ́.
Don't be like that man, that hunter that goes to the to the bush to get game and he doesn't roast it.
Nada bi odeni to lo si oko to peran ti o wa
lafa. As you see in Proverbs chapter 8 verse 9.
Bi ati wo iwe owe orike ejo ese kesan.
Don't be slothful.
Ma se imele.
Apostle Paul was talking to the Romans.
Paul apostle ni ba awon ara Rome soro.
Don't be say be fervent in the spirit.
Oni ninu ise ma se ole.
Serving the Lord.
Ìwé Rome orí kejìlá
ẹsẹ̀ kọkànlá. Yes sir.
Ní ti iṣẹ́ ṣíṣe.
Yes.
Ẹ má ṣe ọ̀lẹ.
Yes.
Ẹ máa ní ìgbónú ọkàn.
Don't be slothful.
Ẹ máa ní ìgbónú ọkàn.
Be fervent in spirit.
Ẹ máa ní ìgbónú ọkàn.
Be fervent in the spirit.
Ẹ máa ní ìgbónú ọkàn.
Let fervency suddenly come upon you.
Jẹ́ kí ìgbónú ọkàn kó bá sórí ayé rẹ.
That is how you can excel at this time.
Nípa bẹ́ẹ̀ ló ṣe lè ṣe àṣeyọrí ní àkókò yìí.
And be mindful.
Kíyèsí dáadáa.
Of how you run your life.
Bí o ṣe ń gbé ìgbé ayé rẹ.
Don't sit idle in Zion.
Má ṣe jókòó káwọ́ gbéra ní Sioni.
Maximize your time.
Lu àkókò rẹ dáradára.
The time is past for you to be wasting your time.
Àkókò ti lọ débi kó o tún máa fàkókò ṣòfò.
God doesn't want you to be idle in Zion.
Ọlọ́run ò fẹ́ kó o jókòó kó o káwọ́ gbéra ní Sioni.
Because our time is fast spent.
Nítorí àkókò ti lọ.
Our time is fast spent.
A ò ní àkókò mọ́.
We have a little time that is left.
A ní àkókò péréte síwájú sí.
You have a little time left.
Àkókò péréte ló kù fún ara.
Do you know when the owner of your life will call him?
Yóò mọ àkókò tí ó kanlẹ̀kùn gba ẹ̀mí rẹ.
What will you give account to God?
Irú ìṣirò wo ló ṣe nígbà tí a bá kanlẹ̀kùn.
And you are still sitting down there.
O sì ti jókòó síbẹ̀.
God has said the same thing to you last year.
Ọlọ́run ti sọ nǹkan kan náà fún ọlọ́run tó kọjá.
He said the same thing to you 5 years ago.
Ó sọ nǹkan náà fún ọbí ọdún márùn-ún sẹ́yìn.
You have no reason to do it.
O dẹ̀ ti dìde láti ṣe.
God is challenging you today.
Ọlọ́run pè ọ níjà lónìí.
Even in your finances.
Nínú okòwò rẹ, inú ètò ìṣúná
rẹ. You know the financial expert.
Ó mọ àwọn akọ́ṣẹ́mọṣẹ́.
They said there is one way to stay solvent.
Wọ́n ní ọ̀nà kan pàtó láti máa ní owó lápò nígbà gbogbo.
Cut down your waste.
Gbogbo àwọn àìbìkítà ohun tó ná owó sí ni tí ò wúlò.
Ọ̀sẹ̀ dànù. Spend more effort to get more revenue.
Àbí kò sa ipá rẹ láti tún ní owó sí.
Some of us have idle assets.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wa la ní àwọn okòwò kan tí a ò lò tí ò wúlò.
We have property that are idle.
A ní àwọn ìdókòwò kan tó kàn wá ń bẹ̀ ṣá.
That deep freezer.
Kíní amómi tuntun tó ń sọ omi di block
oní. You just kept it in one corner.
Osa kan pamọ́ sí kọ́nà kan.
That your iron.
Iron rẹ ni.
You just kept it in one place.
Osa kan tó síbì kan náà ni.
Even some of us cars.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wa tẹ̀tún ní mọ́tò.
That you have not used for years.
Bó o lò fún àwọn ọdún díẹ̀ sẹ́yìn.
You just park it there.
Osa kan tì mọ́ bẹ́ẹ̀.
When they come to you.
Nígbà tó wá tọ̀ wá.
You say àmì ìfẹ́ ta mọ́tò yẹn.
Àmì ìfẹ́ ta mọ́tò yẹn.
Ah, mọ́tò yẹn rán mi létí nígbà tí mo kọ́kọ́ bẹ̀rẹ̀ iṣẹ́.
When I started job, that is my historical car.
Àánú ẹ ṣe mí.
I'm sorry for you.
Ẹni tó ṣe mọ́tò ṣé wọ́n nífẹ̀ẹ́ jù bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ. There's something called time value of money.
Ǹjẹ́ o mọ̀ pé gbogbo ló ní àkókò àti ìgbà
ládọ̀rọ̀? Instead of tying that thing down.
Kàkà kó o máa so mọ́tò ni mọ́lẹ̀.
Somebody needs it.
Ẹnìkan nílò rẹ̀.
If you cannot give it out.
Bó o bá lè dá fún yàn.
Sell it off.
O ṣe tà á.
One day something God taught me a lesson.
Ọlọ́run kọ́ mi ní ẹ̀kọ́ kan lọ́jọ́
kan. I was just sitting down in the house with my wife.
Mo kàn jókòó nílé pẹ̀lú ìyàwó mi ni.
And I had the aboki doing kolokolokolokolo in front of the house.
Wọ́n rí aboki tó ń lu agolo níwájú ilé wa.
And then I called the aboki.
Mo wá pe aboki
ni. I said let me go and test something.
Jẹ́ lọ dán kan wò.
And I have a store where I have jagajaga things.
Mo wá rí àwọn onírúurú irin tí mo ti kó jọ tipẹ́tipẹ́.
And here was I was sitting down, I didn't have money in my pocket.
Mi ìdẹ̀ wa ní owó kankan lápò mi.
So I said aboki come inside.
Mo ní aboki wọlé wá.
I now started packing all the jagajaga.
Mo wá bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní kó àwọn orin tá a lò mọ́ jagajaga.
My wife say kí ni yẹn bá ti ta o, I say please.
My wife say no, say that one, say
Since we have been keeping it.
Nígbà tá a ti kojọ síbẹ̀.
Have we used it? Anything you have not used in the last 6 months, you are not going to need it.
Oh, nilo re mo.
When I saw that those jagajaga,
ngbati mo ta won kan jagajaga,
and I saw money in my pocket,
mo ri owo lapo mi.
I said, ah, I thank God.
Mo dupe lowo Olorun.
Engage your idle assets.
Awon ti o lo money.
Avoid late bills.
Mama pe ko to ma sanwo.
Avoid late bills.
Mama pe ko to ma
We can be on this for a very long time. But for our time, what is God telling us? God is telling us here that we must be wary of our life to make it prudent. We must differentiate between asset and liability. You don't have money to eat. Yes, somebody gave you phone of 120,000.
One for me. Ah, what do you want for money?
If they dash you, can't you sell it off?
It was later.
And use the money to do something
else.
And this phone, you are not even utilizing it.
Oh, your phone when there are become oh, it's a lot near there.
A lot of phone images, Danny.
I saw a bike man carrying two phones.
Kilo fi phone images.
I want to ask, Kidney, what does it do with two phones?
The Lord will help us. Brethren, the Lord will help us. This is a time that we must take heed. And brethren, finally, I'm going to end here. You have to set, it is time to always set goals. Set goals. You should begin to trust God to have short-term goal, middle-term goal, and long-term goal. Every man that did well, they are organized like this. They have a reason why they are living. Jesus had the living while he lived. His counsel was to do his father's work and to complete it. John the Baptist had a reason. He had a mission. He had his set goals. He said that I may decrease and that he may increase. So what is your life goal? What is your life pursuit? What have you put ahead of you? It is no longer time for us to be adversaries. It's no longer time for us to be scattered. And if we trust God to follow these 10 steps, the Lord will help us. And peradventure there is somebody there. You are already sleeping. Everything that is being said is like, what are they talking
about?
May the Lord wake you up from the sleep of death. You know, it was when I was reading finally in the book of Psalm 13:3. I want you to read it. Psalm
13:3.
I discovered that there is a sleep that somebody will sleep unto death. But God will wake us from such sleep. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Ha. May this be your portion. Maybe you are already sleeping. You are demotivated. The environment has dampened your spirit. Even all these 6 steps that God is saying we could take, you are looking at it with unbelief. God is saying the Lord wants to wake you from a dead sleep. And how will you wake up from that dead sleep? How will you receive motivation for it? To be able to do what God is saying. You have to possess his spirit. You have to have the spirit of God, which only comes when you have invited him to your heart. And so I'm admonishing you as we round off now, that how would you be able to survive this time? How will you be able to have the mind of Caleb? How would you be able to have the mind of Joshua?
It is by allowing the Lord Jesus Christ.
Nipa gbigba Jesu Oluwa laye.
It is by allowing the spirit of enablement.
Nipa gbigba emi itunisoke
laye. That comes to a man's heart.
To man wa si okan eniyan.
He says is at the door of our heart.
Oni mo wa ni enu ona mo
ko. And is knocking.
Mo si nkan kun okan
re. He wants to help you in this challenge.
O fe ran Olorun ni akoko yi.
He wants your life to be great.
O fe ki aye re ko gboro.
He wants you to say when others are saying men are, when men are being casted down.
Nipa ta ba so pe igbesile wa.
You are saying as a lifting. And so the opportunity is here for you to begin this journey, even this challenging time, by saying to him today, by bowing down in your heart to say, Father, I've had your word today. I want you to help me. I want you to wake me up from sleep. I want you to wake me from this, from the company of the dead, by bringing into me your spirit of life. I want to be born again. Lord, help me. Let your spirit enter my heart now. And I forsake every counsel of the devil. I accept you into my life as my Lord and personal Savior. That I may receive strength. Even at this time. To overcome the challenges of the time. That I may have a different spirit. Thank you because you have done it.
Baba, mo dupe tori pe ti se.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Ni oruko Jesu ni mo gbadura.
Father, we thank you for your word. Thank you for how you started with us. Thank you for where you have made us to stop at this time. Thank you because, Lord, this word shall germinate in the heart of men. It will do us good. It will propel our hearts. It will teach us the way to go, even at these challenging times. Father, we bless you, Daddy. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Thank you very much. God bless you. In Jesus' name.